Praise the Lord today. Hallelujah, saints. It's good to be with you again. Praise God. We always enjoy coming and sharing the truth of God's word and what the Lord's laid on our heart to share every day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Go ahead and pray. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, I pray that you will touch this broadcast, anoint this broadcast, Lord, to pierce the hearts of people, Lord. And do the work that you sent it forth to do, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Hallelujah. And that he will do. Hallelujah. Praise God. Today's message, Earthquake of Release. And we've been in Revelation this week, and I want to read here out of Revelation chapter 6, beginning at verse 12. And I beheld when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake. A great earthquake. Oh, hallelujah. And the sun became black as sackcloth of hair. And the moon became as blood. And the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casteth her untimely figs when she is shaken of a mighty wind. And the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together. And every mountain and air and island were moved out of their places, and the kings of the earth, and the great men, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman, and every free man hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains, and said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us. Hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand?
When the Lord moves, boy, oh
I'm
boy.
Telling you. Now that completes chapter 6. Now, this is an event that's going to take place soon. Very soon. Now, today's message, we're not going to really speak so much about this except to say that it is a, for the wicked, it's a release from all of their concerns about their life here and now, okay? And all their concerns, you know how the wicked are always only concerned about their self and what's going to happen to them, okay? And how they can get ahead, and they're prideful, and they're proud, and they're lofty, and they're always thinking in their mind what they're going to do today to make things better for their self. This is the idea. This is the principle of the fallen nature. It wants to exalt itself. Okay, so this earthquake that's going to take place is going to be a release for them from that sort of thing, because they're going to be looking for the rocks and everything to hide them from the wrath of the Lamb. Okay, so they're going to be released from their concern about going to the bank, so to speak, okay, and checking on their account, so to speak, or what they're thinking about today. You follow what I'm saying?
Well, the focus is going to be what's coming down upon their head, basically.
Exactly. But look what it says. It says, and they said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us. Okay. So they're not saying, hey, what are we going to do this weekend, Jim? You know, we're going to go boating, or we're going to go fishing, or what are we going to do to please ourselves? You see, this is not going to be the concern anymore, because when this earthquake takes place, it's going to be, they're going to be saying to the rocks and the mountains, fall on us and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb.
Well, it's all over then.
I know.
Yeah.
For them.
It's all over then for the wicked, because, right, you know, the Lord has his arms stretched out now.
Right. Of mercy.
And mercy.
And grace.
And calling and calling and calling. But there will come a day when, you know, there isn't going to be no turning from that day.
Right.
It's going to be all over. And the decision that was made is going to be an eternal decision. And so
Many people are making that decision today.
Yeah, right now today. And the thing is, you know, this is a call. This message right here today is a call to the wicked to come before it's too late.
Amen.
Before the rocks fall.
Amen.
Before everything is moved out of its place.
Praise God.
By the almighty hand of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
You know, there's a big difference in this day in the wicked and the righteous, because there is a joy-filled day, really, for the righteous, because they can look up and see that their King has come.
Hallelujah.
Our King has come.
Amen. Amen.
And we can see Him coming by what His mighty arm is doing in the earth.
Praise God. I want to read here out of Acts 16 now, because this earthquake of release is coming not only to destroy the wicked, okay, and all the cities of the nations are going to fall, it says in Revelation chapter 16, when this earthquake takes place, and the hail is going to fall, and it's going to be an awesome, awesome manifestation of God's power and of His finished work that He completed when Jesus died on the cross. It's all done right then. Jesus said it's finished. This kingdom of darkness is defeated now. And so what we're seeing is the manifestation of this taking place in the earth today. And we're going to see it more and more. And for the believer, for you, saint of the Most High God, for us who are walking with Jesus and we're pressing in, we're in the school of Christ, we're learning more how to die to self, we're taking up our cross and following the Lord. I want you to see here how it says right here. Here's what happened. Okay. And it came to pass, chapter 16 of Acts, verse 16. It came to pass as we went to prayer, a certain damsel possessed with a spirit of divination met us, which brought her masters much gain by soothsaying. The same followed Paul and us, cried, saying, these men are the servants of the Most High God, which show unto us the way of salvation. And this did she many days. But Paul, being grieved, turned and said to the Spirit, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out the same hour. And when her masters saw that the hope of their gains was gone, they caught Paul and Silas and drew them into the marketplace under the rulers, and brought them to the magistrates, saying, these men being Jews do exceedingly trouble our city, and teach customs which are not lawful for us to receive, neither to observe, being Romans. And the multitude rose up against them. And the magistrates rent off their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely. Who, having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. They're in the deepest part of the prison. They're chained up, okay? Now, I'm telling you right now, today, many of God's people, the cares of this life have been growing up for many years in your life, and it's choking off the life of Christ, and it's hurting you, because, and you don't know how to be free from it. You don't know, you're afraid, some of you, to just let go of the world and forget about all the stuff that you laid your heart upon when you were 20 years old. Now you're 40 years old. You've been working and working and working and working and working, trying to get ahead, trying to get ahead. It's always trying to get more and get ahead. When Christ says He is your head, when Christ says He is your rest, Christ says He is your retirement, okay? Retire to Christ right now and let Christ fill you, and then all this other stuff won't matter. Won't matter, okay? But see, the cares of this life, the Lord showed me, the deceitfulness of riches, the thorns growing up, He's going to do away with that. He's going to cut the thorn tree. And what He's going to do is He's going to check the evil on the earth. Evil is spread worldwide, saints, from one end of Babylon to the other. It's the whole earth, the whole terra firma that we walk on is Babylon. The whole world order. Jesus didn't pray for that. He's done away with that world order. He's brought in His order. Hallelujah. And He's planted it in our heart. And He says, you live like I lived. Hallelujah. And here's the power to do so. You want to say something about that? Praise God, I saw you fixing to talk and say something. But look here. Paul and Silas are in this deep prison. They're down there, okay? And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake. Great earthquake. Hallelujah. So that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's bands were loosed. Hallelujah. This earthquake we read about here in Revelation 6. This earthquake, it's also mentioned in Revelation 11. Okay. And let me go there because that's important to see that. And I believe it's indicative of the Lord to have it right here. When the seventh angel sounds his trumpet, okay, it's almost as if this earthquake in chapter 6 is just massive earthquake all over the earth, okay? The whole earth shaking. And then in chapter 11, we see this. The two witnesses have given their testimony. Hallelujah. And the same hour, verse 13, was there a great earthquake, and the tenth part of the city fell. And in the earthquake were slain of men 7,000, and the remnant were affrighted and gave glory to the God of heaven. Mm. Hallelujah. Okay. This is a great earthquake right here.
Deliverance.
Deliverance. See? Because the two witnesses were raised up. See? When Jesus comes back, resurrection. Hallelujah. But look, the earthquake's coming. Look what's going to happen right here. There was a great earthquake so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were open and everyone's bands were loosed. And the keeper of the prison, awaking out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled. But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, "Do thyself no harm, for we are all here." Then he called for a light and sprang in and trembling, and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas, and brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved in thy house." And they spake unto him the word of the Lord, and to all that were in his house. And he took them the same hour of the night, and washed their stripes, and was baptized, he and all his straightway. And when he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them, and rejoiced, believing in God with all his house. Now look. The earthquake opened the door for Paul and Silas. Yeah, deliverance.
You know, there was like, that's a prime example for us of the deliverance of the Lord, because Paul and Silas, I mean, they were in chains. To them, you know, there wasn't any getting out of there.
That's right.
And so they just started singing to the Lord. And as they sang to the Lord, that's an example for us.
That's right, exactly. God will shake.
Worship.
He will shake the circumstances around us in such a way where we will be delivered, okay? At the same time that we're delivered, those that are up are what?
Down.
Coming down, see?
That's what the Bible says.
That's right.
And, you know, we can have that earthquake, that trembling in our spirit, you know. And I felt that very thing this morning, reading the Word early.
Ooh,
is that
God.
Trembling, that earthquake basically inside, where you just sense the Spirit of God so strong, you're just trembling, just like an earthquake inside. And you know, the Lord is a God of deliverance in every area. He is a God of deliverance.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
And as we look to Him and trust Him, and know that He is the God of deliverance, that He is our help, that He is our hope, He does not disappoint.
Hallelujah.
His promises are true. And as we stand upon His promises, you know, just like Paul and Silas, you know, they knew who their God was.
Hallelujah.
Even though they were in a situation, hey, in the natural realm, there's no way out of here. But they weren't looking in the natural realm, were they?
They were focused on the Lord.
Otherwise,
the
they wouldn't have been worshiping in that situation, were
Amen.
They?
That's
Would
right.
they be if they were focused on
their self,
yeah,
and
what
what's
kind of
going on with them.
situation they were
Amen.
in.
That's it.
And so as they looked heavenward, what happened?
Right.
Whoa.
Let me get back
God
to this.
Moved.
You know what I was saying earlier about the cares of this life? See, right now, God's people in the Western nations, in America, Canada, you know, all the Western nations in Europe and Australia, we love the Lord. We're walking with the Lord, okay? This is the church at large I'm just talking about now. Everybody's at a different level in Christ. But there's a lot of concerns about all the circumstances that we have to deal with in this world, okay? In this Babylon where we're in Babylon. We're not of the world, but we're in the world, okay? So when this earthquake happens, and it could be an economic earthquake, it could be a political earthquake, it could be a literal earthquake of the earth. Whatever God does, what he's going to do is it's going to release us from all of this cares about all this stuff. It's not going to matter. I mean, think about it right now. Everything we're doing in this world today, that's going on in this world, in the business world, economics, politics, religion. What happens if the Lord comes down and just turns off the electricity? Okay. In other words, your generators won't work. No electricity at all, ever again, as far as we know.
Well, they say one of those
EMP, an EMP blast can do that.
Will do that.
But I'm talking about no electricity. How is that going to affect our lives? What's it going to do to us? It's going to release us from all those cares, okay? Because we'll have to, and that's what God says he wants to do right now. He wants to release us from all those cares. Paul and Silas, they were released, okay, from the worry or from the bondage of prison. They were released from this bondage that they were in. And then what happened? Look what happened. I want to read this right here. Hallelujah. And when it was day, the magistrates sent the sergeant saying, let those men go. Now here's the government beating them, whipping them, throwing them into jail. And then they come the next day and say, hey, you let these guys go. And that's what the wicked do. They'll beat you, they'll slander you, and then they'll say, all right, they're okay. Let them go. See? And God has another story here. And the keeper of the prison told this saying to Paul, the magistrates have sent to let you go. Now therefore depart and go in peace. But Paul said unto them, they have beaten us openly and condemned, openly uncondemned, being Romans, and have cast us into prison. And now do they thrust us out privily? Nay, verily. But let them come themselves and fetch us out. You see, who's in the ascendancy now? Paul is. You see what I'm saying? This is what God's going to do. Behold, verse 1 of chapter 24 of Isaiah says, the Lord maketh the earth empty, and maketh it waste, and turneth it upside down, and scattereth abroad the inhabitants thereof. Okay? This is what is coming. This is what God is fixing to do in this earth. And it shall be as with the people, so with the priests. See, the priests were a class of people that were above the normal people, okay? But here it says, and it shall be as with the people, the poor,
everybody the same,
so with the priests. You go to these Central American countries, saints, and the Roman Catholic hierarchy, they have a stronghold in South America, Central America, and really all over the earth, the Roman Catholic Church. But you see these bishops and these priests living like kings. I mean, they're living sumptuous lives, and the peasants aren't. But right here it says, and it shall be as with the people, so with the priest. As with the servant, so with his master. As with the maid, so with her mistress. As with the buyer, so with the seller. Everybody's going to be on the same level. As with the lender, so with the borrower. As with the taker of usury, so with the giver of usury to him. The land shall be utterly empty and utterly spoiled. For the Lord hath spoken this word. The Lord hath spoken this word. And it will take place.
What does that mean? Utterly spoiled.
Utterly spoiled.
Utterly emptied.
Right?
That's pretty intense right there.
That's right. It's like a robber. Spoiled.
Utterly emptied. See what that one is.
Utterly emptied. Oh, I see.
Mm-hmm.
To pour out. That is
depopulate.
to depopulate,
Ooh.
to spread out.
Wow.
But see, for us, it's a release. Okay? We're in Christ, and in Christ, He is over us with His wings protecting us. He has His holy angels around us. Does it mean we won't suffer? Hey, we're suffering now in many areas in the spirit. Many of us, we're going through battles against the forces of darkness, against people wagging their tongues against us, things like this, people praying against us. We go through battles every day.
And those across the oceans that are really going through.
Right. The believers,
know,
yeah, in other lands.
Physical torture.
That's right.
And, you know, spiritual torture. And but yet, they're so close to the Lord, you know.
Amen.
And it really kind of makes American Christians ashamed because, you know, we're not going through those type of trials that our sisters and brothers are going through over there. But yet it seems like any little thing is a giant trial to us.
Right.
And we make it into a big balloon trial. But I think if we would look at those, our brothers and sisters across the seas, and what they're going through for the sake of the name, you know, we would tend to keep our mouth closed about things
Amen.
More
Amen.
So than we do.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And, you know, I know the Lord is intensely getting His people ready for what's coming. And there is something coming not very long away. And
He'll have us ready.
You know, I know He's working on all of us to draw us closer to Him and in His presence and communion with Him so that we will be sure and hear His voice.
Amen.
Hear His instruction in this hour.
Praise the Lord.
And that's crucial.
Amen, it is.
Very crucial.
Hallelujah. Look what happened here. Paul said, let Him come fetch us out. And the sergeants told these words unto the magistrates, and they feared when they heard that they were Romans. And they came and besought them and brought them out and desired them to depart out of the city. And they went out of the prison and entered into the house of Lydia. And when they had seen the brethren, they comforted them and departed. So this earthquake of release for Paul and Silas, it'll be similar in our lives, and it has been. And we're going to see God just miraculously open doors of opportunity, doors of wealth, if you will, in the spirit, okay, to go forward in Christ and speak forth His word with the authority that He is, okay? Because we're not fearing man any longer. When we were in Babylon, we always were afraid of this or afraid of that. But when we came to Christ, we fear only God now. Hallelujah. And I'm not saying that fear don't hit us. I'm not saying that sometimes we don't fall into fear, because we do. But what happens? The Holy Spirit reassures us. He reminds us, I've not given you that spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. And you walk in the boldness of the Lord. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. And when God begins to judge this earth in earthquakes, volcanoes, floods, whatever He uses, whirlwinds, we are going to be the ones in the ascendancy, because we're going to be in peace. But the world and the wicked, they're going to blaspheme God. They're going to judge God as being evil for sending these plagues upon them. Okay? And let me tell you, they will point the finger at us. But don't worry. Don't fear. See? Don't matter. Because the land shall be utterly emptied and utterly spoiled. For the Lord hath spoken this word. The earth mourneth. Verse 4 of chapter 24 of Isaiah. And fadeth away. The world languisheth. And fadeth away. The haughty people of the earth do languish. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, praise God. Hallelujah. Languishing in theirs, to droop, to be sick, to mourn, to wag, to be weak and wax feeble. Okay.
Oh, so haughty.
Hallelujah. Haughty. Altitude. elevated place, okay, figurative
aloft.
elation, you know, dignity, haughty height, you know, most high, on high. They think they're somebody today, but when God turns the world upside down, it's going to be over for the haughty, okay?
Yeah, that's a sobering, very sobering thing.
Let's just give a scenario, okay? Go to San Bernardino and head west, and it's 80 miles to Los Angeles, okay? 80 miles of cement, 80 miles of cement ponds all the way. I mean, this is a big area of the United States, very heavily populated, okay? And there's people of all different stations of life, okay? From top to bottom, multi-millionaires, okay? And all the way down to poor people in the homeless shelter, or even on the street, no homeless shelter. And then all of a sudden, here comes a magnitude 8.2 earthquake straight through there, okay? And the whole town is without electricity. There's no running water, and every one of those people instantly are on the same level, just like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And the haughty who were high and lifted up in their big fancy offices and buildings, what happens to them? They're trapped. They're teetering. They're falling. See? And these things are going to happen, but where's the believer going to be? He's going to be where? In peace. When the shaking stops, they'll be in peace. They'll know, okay, this is when it's happening, this is God's work. Our friend in San Jose in that earthquake that hit Napa Valley recently, about a month ago or so, he was at work when the earthquake hit, and he looked over at the clock, and it said 3:21, 3:21 a.m., 3:21. It's like countdown, you know. It was a powerful thing for him. I got holy bumps thinking about it, and he said, man, the Lord just touched him real mightily, showed him countdown, 3:21. And I'm telling you, and it's not only L.A. and San Francisco and San Diego and all the western nations, western state over there. It's also on up into Oregon and Seattle and Washington, the Midwest, you know, the New Madrid Fault and the East. There's earthquakes over. There have been gigantic earthquakes. I was looking this morning. In Boston, there's been big earthquakes in Charleston. I mean, God's going to shake this planet. He's going to shake it.
You know, the Lord gives signs, too. He's given signs along the way. And we saw a picture of Mount Rainier.
Yeah, yesterday.
And there were two big, huge, double cap type clouds, orange-like cap clouds.
Right over
the top of it. And the first thing that came to me when I saw that is an eruption. And, you know, if Mount Rainier were to erupt, it would be bad news. And I know years ago, well, that is one in Oregon where they had a forest beneath that lake.
You mean Mount St. Helens?
No. It's out in Oregon. And it's under the water.
Oh, the one we were watching that documentary about the earthquake.
So that's happened before out in that area. But see, the thing is, and, you know, there's other signs. You know, this morning there was like an eclipse of the moon. And we were talking about that and how, you know, the eclipse, the earth comes in front of there.
Right, in front of the sun.
Yeah, and we were talking about that this morning, how the earthly things cloud the church.
It clouds the glory of the Lord
it,
Jesus.
It eclipses it, you know. Right. It messes it up, in other words, you know. And then, you know, the other morning, early in the morning, the horn just went off on the truck.
Yeah, all by itself.
All by itself. Just started blowing, and it was going, brrr, just kept doing it. And John was trying to figure out
what it was, so I just finally pulled the wire off of it.
And it's like God is, and this was early, what was it, 2?
It was about 3:30 in the morning.
And
4 o'clock or something.
So, you know, the Lord gives signs, you know, it's like the alarm. It's like an alarm. And we need to pay attention to those signs.
Amen.
The Lord gives us personal signs showing us what is to come. In different kinds of ways. And so, You know, we have to just be on the solid rock, because no matter if the earth moves in the natural, or if this earth that we live in, this temple, moves in the natural, in a quaking sort of position, we can still stand and be on the rock that is solid and that
Amen.
Does not move.
That's right.
Does not move. You know, it comes to me about Elijah. And he was there and he put his head between his knees when he prayed for rain. And his head was where probably his ears were covered by his knees. And of course his eyes were closed. And that was like a sign that he was not going to let anything enter in to his eyes or his ears to interrupt his
good.
Faith in God.
Amen.
And look on something that would cause him to doubt, or hear something that would cause him to doubt, you know, that God was going to answer that prayer about the rain.
Amen.
And then when he knew, you know, God was answering, he told the guy, go look. Well, he came back with a bad report, didn't he? Well, Elijah,
seven times
he didn't give up, because you know why? Because he knew he had heard from God, you know.
That's right, that's right.
I mean, he had his physical ears and eyes closed out to the earthly thing.
He knew that his faith would be sight. He would see it.
Spiritual.
Amen.
Spiritual.
Amen.
He was totally... He refused to let any of the earthly stuff in.
Right, right.
To mess up his connection with God.
Amen.
See?
Amen.
And that's an example for us, too. You know, because I believe as this time goes on, the Lord's going to give us more signs and more knowings about what he's fixing to do.
Praise God.
It says he does that. He'll tell the prophet before he does something.
Hallelujah.
And that's always been true,
that's
hasn't
right.
it?
Yes.
So, you know, we need to pay attention. Pay attention to the instructions of the Lord. And
God wants us to be helping people right now. Okay? Don't wait for an earthquake in your city to get out there and start helping people.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's always something we can all do to help someone else, you know, today. And so let's get used to doing that. When we see people that need and are in need, let's try to help them, okay? As the Lord directs us and shows us. And the thing is that I see God fixing to move so mightily, hon, that it's just going to be just like a, it's going to blow us all away, you know? And it's going to be a release of sorts, because he's going to level the playing field, so to speak, okay? Even in the church, he's going to do it, because in the church, you have a lot of haughtiness, a lot of pride and arrogance in the body of Christ, because people think they're better than other people,
mm-hmm.
maybe because they have a better education, or maybe because they have a better house, or better, or more money, or whatever. I mean, we've seen that, you know, people look at us like a certain way because we're not where they are, you know, as far as stature of life goes. You know what I mean?
That's not what counts with God.
I know it. I know it. I mean... So. But we've witnessed this, we've experienced it ourselves, and I'm sure many people hearing this have as well. But the release is coming, and it's the earthquake of release. I believe God's got a big earthquake in store for this planet, and there's nothing man can do to stop it. And I, you know, you're not going to give HARP any
credit
for this one. I mean, and people do that. It's crazy, because God is sovereign over
all things.
Yeah,
they give the heart machine the credit for what God is doing.
I mean, they might have these weapons and all these things that they can, you know, make the earth shake and all that.
But they can't do it without His
God has to approve it.
Sovereignty.
And, you know, it'll be bigger than anything that man has ever experienced. What did we read about recently about an earthquake at... There was an earthquake somewhere, and it lasted for like a minute or two. It was just shaking for a long time.
I think they said 5 to 7 minutes it lasted, something like that.
It was like, this is like a big earthquake. It's like, I mean, I'm telling you, it's going to be bigger than that. It's going to be the hugest earthquake the world has ever seen, and God's going to level the playing field. And if you know Christ, you're going to be in the ascendancy, okay, at that hour. We're supposed to be now, but in that hour, you're going to see, oh, because God reveals what's in man. God shows man himself, and the earthquakes come, and the devastation comes, and if people repent and trust in God, they'll be saved. The Bible says all who call upon him will be saved in that day. But it also says many people won't repent. They'll shake their fist in God's face.
Amen. You know, the Lord says, I will set a table before you in the presence of your enemies.
Hallelujah.
And I'm going to give a testimony of, you know, we're talking about earthquakes, the moving of the earth. And, you know, God does that. God does that. You know, they might have certain machines that can instigate a little bit of something, but God does that. God's the one that does it, and he's the one that allows any tampering with his creation. Allows, only for a certain time.
Amen.
But this testimony about the moving of the earth, you know, I had a sense in my spirit that there was going to be an earthquake, and I just began to pray. I said, Lord, I pray that you will not let this ground where we are move at all. As far down as the ground is, don't let one single thing on this place move at all. And so in the night, there was an earthquake. And it woke up the person down the road on our right and shook their place good.
He was about 2 miles away.
Yeah, and then it woke up the person the other direction.
And he's about half a mile away.
And did the same thing. But where we were, the ground did not move.
We didn't wake up.
At all.
It woke them up. It was 11 o'clock at night.
Yeah,
woke them up right out of bed.
So.
And we didn't. We just slept right there.
So the Lord can keep the ground where his children are still.
Amen.
And everything around it can be moving and waving, and which is what happens in an earthquake. The ground literally moves like an ocean. But he can keep the ground still where God's people are.
Amen.
And proof of it is what he did that night.
That's right.
And so, you know, we have a mighty God.
Amen.
It's what do we believe about our God? Okay? Do we believe he's mighty? Do we believe he can do that?
Hallelujah.
Do we trust him to do that?
Yes.
Do we trust him in that kind of way to keep us in that kind of way?
Amen. We do.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God's people trust God.
Yeah. And
Hallelujah.
So the belief has to be, my God can do anything.
Praise the Lord.
Anything.
And he can.
Yes, he can.
He doesn't have to abide by man's rules.
No.
Hallelujah.
And so, you know, it's mighty, and it should put a big old smile on everybody's face.
Hallelujah. There's one on mine.
Yeah. Because he makes us smile all the time with the things that he does.
Amen.
It's just amazing. It's just amazing.
Little things like those apples. I told that story before about the apples, and we went to the grocery store, and we didn't have the money to get apples, and sometimes they have apples on sale, you know, when it's that season, and so Sharon wanted some apples, and we didn't have it, so, but we go back out to the truck, and there's a bag of apples in the back of the truck, you see. See, God can do anything,
well, not only
and
that,
he laid it on this lady's heart to put those apples in our truck with a little note on them,
mm-hmm.
See. And knowing that Sharon wanted some apples, this God cares about
thing.
Every little thing. And in the, go ahead. I don't want you to lose that thought. But.
And, you know, just the simplest things, it's amazing. I just have a big old smile because, you know, this is just a simple thing that when we did our garden and I did all the plants up in cups, well, somehow some of this stuff must have got mixed up. And I thought that four of these plants were kale plants because they looked kind of like kale. And then we came to the part where
we're harvesting the leaves.
Yeah, some of the things
we're drinking
didn't
the
come,
kale.
Some
we're
of the
drinking
things
the kale,
didn't
right?
come up. You know, I was wanting to plant broccoli. And I came to the end, I said, oh Lord, I wish I had got those plants up on broccoli or whatever. Well, now here all of a sudden, in the last couple of days, I see these little heads forming on what I thought was kale. And here it was, broccoli. Four big old huge healthy plants of broccoli. And I'm just smiling. I'm saying, Lord, you know, you are so good. I mean, just the simplest little things you think about.
Right.
Now, if he cares about those simple little things, think about the big things.
Right. He does
think
care.
About what he's going to do about the big things.
Right.
You know, that might weigh kind of on us, you know, about stuff.
And let me,
cares about these
right.
things.
And like our brother Jonathan, he lives out in California. And we talked to him about this, you know. God's going to have him and the other believers in the very specific spot he wants them on the day that a major earthquake will take place there. You know, and it could be, he could be totally out of the whole area of California when it hits. It could be, I mean, whatever God wants, well, he will have him right there. And anyone else that belongs to the Lord in that city or in San Francisco or LA or wherever, God will have his people precisely where he wants them to be in that hour. And so how do we know this? Because we know today God has our day planned for us. We make a plan, God directs our steps, it says in Proverbs 16. So Sharon and I are planning to do certain things today that we know need to get done. But we've learned, let God direct our steps.
Mm-hmm.
Because if God's wanting to do something else, and I insist on doing what I've planned, then I block the Holy Spirit. I can dam him up, see. Because I know that the Lord moves in mysterious ways. This is what the Word of God teaches us. God, he's doing things we can't see fully everything he's doing. Okay? So let's be open and trust in the Lord, because he's going to have us where he wants. There's an earthquake of release coming, I'm telling
Amen.
You.
Amen. You know, it's just coming to me about the earthquake when Paul and Silas were in the jail. There was things that didn't need to be with them that fell off during the earthquake. Their chains.
Hallelujah.
Fell off
that's
during
right.
the earthquake.
And that's what's going to happen,
and
I'm telling
you. And it seems,
you
know, the Lord just gave me a revelation about that, is this shaking is going to do that very thing.
Amen.
You know, with my people.
That's it.
That are kind of chained up and stuff.
Chained up with the ways
yeah,
of the world.
And the
that's
ways
right.
of the world
right.
and maybe bondages or whatever. This shaking is going to shake loose those things.
Hallelujah.
And they're things you don't need anyway.
Hallelujah.
Don't need anyway as a child of God. So God's going to shake them loose.
Hallelujah.
And, you know, it's important for us to submit to what God's doing in that way.
Give him the glory.
Give him the glory, because he is worthy of it all.
Right. And when we don't trust the Lord fully, it stifles the Holy Spirit. So let's say, Lord, make me a trustful, faithful follower of you. And in everything, in every single thing, everything. Okay? I mean, we can all speak out of our mouth, I trust the Lord. When we do, we trust the Lord. But when the rubber meets the road, so to speak, that hard time comes, are we quick to run to man, or do we run to the Lord and we trust the Lord? We have a sister, and she's living by herself now, and she's learning to hear the Lord in a different way than always having someone else around. See, and you experienced that, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
And that's something
God
else
has
that
to
will
do
take
that
place
with his people.
Right.
And I believe he's doing that big time with his people right now. He's like getting us off to ourselves with him, to deal one-on-one in our hearts, one-on-one with us in every area, to be purged of anything and everything that can be a hook
right.
there to pull us away in that time. Because there's, you know, when things start falling, I mean, hey, it's going to be a big time thing, you know. And if our heart's not right, that's no time to get your heart right.
I mean, well, you don't mean that, like, don't get your heart right, but
no.
You mean be prepared now.
Right.
Get your heart prepared now so that you don't have to worry about being prepared then.
Right, because, you know, in the midst of something like that, I don't know if people really will come, because they'll be in such fear.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. That's why there's so many calls going forth right now. And, you know, the horn going off like it did, it was just like, hey, the alarm is sounding.
Right.
Right now.
Right.
The opportunity is right now. And as the word says, now is the day of salvation.
Right. If today you hear his voice, right. Harden not your heart.
Right.
As in the provocation.
Right. Well, why do you think the Lord would say such a thing? Because he's saying, hey, it's not time, you know, for you to drag this thing out and just think you got all the time in the world, because you don't.
Right. That's right.
That's why he said,
time is
now
running out.
Is the day.
Time's running out for this
yes.
world. Time's running
yes,
out
it is.
For all this world order the way it is. And it's a big lie and a deception of the devil that this world's going to continue on like it is forever. It's not. It's going to end.
Well,
and when it ends, where are we going to be? We're going to be in Christ. We're going to be in Christ, and we're going to be faithful by his grace, because we're going to respond to him today. And we're going to cooperate with the Holy Spirit, and we're going to surrender
Amen.
More, and we're going to walk with him. This is what we need to be focused on, the Lord Jesus Christ, not the world.
See? Amen. You know, I was thinking of that scripture about, it talks about, you know, they'll name their lands after their self.
Right.
And
yeah.
stuff.
Yeah.
And think they're just going to go on and on and on.
Yeah. Psalm 73.
You know, name yeah. their lands after their self and all their stuff and everything. After their self, and think that that's just going to be the way it is, when that fast the Lord can require
that's it.
Their soul. Well, he says that. This day I require your soul. And where are they at with all that? Empty, naked, without Christ. So now is the day of salvation. Now is the day.
Today.
Now is the time.
Amen.
We are in the day of preparation.
Praise God.
Most definitely. We are in that day. We are in the end times. And I believe the Lord shows his people very often signs that show them that.
Amen. That's right.
In
we
one
saw
way
one
or
this
another.
Morning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One way or another.
Because, see, the earthquake of release, it's coming, and it has come for many people. And when it hits, it's going to be a turning over, okay? It's going to be a turning over of the way things are, because God is able to do that. And we know in 1811, when that earthquake hit New Madrid, that Mississippi River flowed backwards, okay? I mean, God is mighty God. And the things, how we're all looking at everything as concerns the church and the Lord and walking with the Lord, God's going to do some adjusting, okay?
Well,
in all of our thinking, God's mm-hmm. going to do some adjusting, but it's going to be, Jesus said, in the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. He's overcome everything. Jesus has overcome. And we're in Christ, man.
You
Hallelujah.
Know, it's amazing, because it was just coming to me what the Lord showed us years ago. That, you know, there's going to be such an earthquake that will affect even, you know, parts of Arkansas. To the point of dividing it.
Right. Right.
Totally dividing it. And the bottom half being
gone. Right.
And so, I mean, right now is the time to get right
Amen.
With God.
Amen.
Right now.
Amen.
And that's all over the world. There's different places. I'm sure that God has shown other people that live in different places such things. We have to know who our God is, and we need to know who God is in us, too.
Amen. Hallelujah.
He's able to keep us.
Praise His holy name. Thank you, Jesus.
When there doesn't seem to be any kind of way, He's able to keep us.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
And we should trust Him and know that He loves us and cares for us as a child. I think of that picture where the hands of the Lord is holding that little child.
Mm-hmm.
And the hands are totally covering that child in protection.
Right.
And that's what He does. He protects us.
That's it.
He Amen. Protects His people. You know, and I'm not saying some of God's people don't lose their life, because they do. But still, there's even a protection in that, in the fact that, hey, their heart is right with God.
That's right.
And they're going to a better place to be with Him.
That's right.
For eternity.
Hallelujah.
So, you know, the important thing is to be ready. Because, you know, when you're in the midst of a pretty heavy-duty earthquake, you're not thinking about anything. I mean, it's going to be hard for people to come to the Lord in that kind of situation.
You know, some people it will be, and a lot of people will harden their heart more, but there will be those backsliders, and there will be those who have heard the message before, maybe 3 years ago, somebody planted a seed in them, and somebody quoted that scripture, call upon the name of the Lord and shall be saved, you know. Mm-hmm. And so there'll be certain people, the Holy Spirit knows who they are, because the Holy Spirit responds to contriteness. He responds to true brokenness, okay? And in the midst of a mighty cataclysm, some people will be truly broken. I believe this. And God will reap a mighty harvest. And it'll be instantaneous. But there's a lot of people that won't, though, a whole lot, you know. And I don't know who they are. I mean, God knows. But let's pray, you know. Let's pray that many people will come, even today, to the Lord. Don't wait for the great big shaking. Come right now. Hallelujah.
See? You know, I was thinking of even situations where we are, where people maybe are fearful of things to come. And because of the fear, they join up with a group that is not right, is not a true gospel.
Right.
You know, maybe because of things that they may receive from the people, help or whatever like that, or friendship or whatever. They'll compromise and be in that situation. But see, listen, the Word of God says, if you do that, basically, you're going to partake of what those people are going to partake of. So you're really not protected if you're doing that.
That's right.
Basically, according to the Word of God.
I want to pray. Let's pray. Because I want to pray this too. Father God, I ask You this morning, Lord, and today, that Father, I ask that You would help us all to really let You, Holy Spirit, examine our hearts to see if there's any area in any of our lives where we compromise the truth, Lord. Because we don't want to compromise the truth. We have to guard against this, Father. Lord, we don't want no one to take our crown, Father. Lord, we want to do what You say to do and walk where You say to walk and to speak what You say to speak and to be the victorious soldiers that You call us, Lord. The victorious warriors that You say we are, because Your word says so we are, Lord. We want to walk in that today. When this earthquake happens, Lord, it's going to be a release. It's going to be a release for every person on this earth, Lord, in one way or another. And for Your people, it's going to be a release unto glory, a release unto praise and worship unto You, Father. But for the wicked, Lord, it'll be a release to doom, to damnation, to judgment. Father God, we ask You to save souls today. Lord, we praise You for this prophetic word today that You've spoken, Lord, because I can see it, Lord, clearly. And I know You're going to show us more about this. Lord, we pray for those who are going through it right now in the fire, Lord, in the flood. We pray for those, Lord, who are experiencing earthquakes right now in their lives, Father, with children, loved ones, work, whatever. that you would touch them today, Lord. Let your peace be upon them. Save their souls, God, to the uttermost. We pray for those lost, Lord, that you're calling in, that you touch them today and draw them to the Son, Father. Hallelujah. We pray for the backslider, the rebellious, the ones with their heels dug in the ground, Lord, and they don't want to walk with you. They always want to resist you. We pray you break that spirit of resistance off their lives, God. Break it off them in Jesus' name by the blood of the Lamb. We pray, Lord, that you will crush every demonic force that tries to hinder you from having your way in your church today. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We praise and bless you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That was a powerful word today. And there's more to it, I'm sure, because Father's mysterious. I mean, He's God Almighty God, and we need to love Him. No matter what we see with our eyes or hear with our ears today, we love the Lord. We give Him our whole life. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. You can write us here, beholdanewthing@yahoo.com. Beholdanewthing@yahoo.com.
I want to also thank those of you that have supported this work and, you know, the gifts that you've sent. You know, people, they have such a heart for God. There are people that have a heart for God. And I tell you, when we receive these gifts of handmade things and just things that little desires the Lord gives us in our heart, and here it is that, you know, they sent it.
Yeah,
it's like,
yeah.
It just so blesses us, you know. And I remember a couple of years back as well, a little sister handmade us a couple of hats for winter.
Oh, yeah.
And we still use those hats.
Yeah, that's right.
And
praise God for our sister.
I tell you, it's like we just thank you guys. We thank you for your gifts. And
we thank the Lord. We bless God for
yes,
it.
We do. He's the first.
Amen.
And we praise the Lord and ask Him to bless you in a mighty way. And we thank the Lord that He has laid it on their hearts to support
yeah.
the
Amen.
Work.
Yeah.
And, you know, even I have to just say, you know,
okay.
John is really a coffee drinker. And the Lord just really blessed him with a lot of coffee.
Hallelujah.
First from one place and then from another, which was a real blessing too. And
yeah.
I mean, it's just these simple things.
Yeah.
And God just, He cares.
That's right.
And you hear that? Oh, God's
Thunder.
Voice.
Yeah. We're God having... does care, and he promises to take care of His children, you know. And that's the beauty of it. God does it, you know.
Yeah.
Let's just love God, and let's just let God love us, and let's try not to have any hindrances in His way. I mean, you know, being a parent, can you imagine you want to show some love to your children and then they resist you? You know how that makes you feel, you know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You think about how God feels, because He's so much holier and so far above us. How it makes Him feel when He's reaching out in love to us and then we resist Him. Oh no, let's don't never resist God. Let Him have His way today.
Amen.
Let Him do with us what He wants to do, man. Let Him wake us up with an earthquake today in some kind of way where it makes us go, Amen, God, hallelujah, okay, I got it, hallelujah. You see what I mean? Because it doesn't always have to be. That's what this message, this word is about. The earthquake of release is not always unto destruction. It's unto glory. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Just what I felt this morning reading the word.
Amen.
You know, just that quaking inside, the trembling inside. You know, I also want to thank those of you that have prayed for us.
Amen.
You know, prayer
yes.
is such a foundation.
Oh, hallelujah.
Without prayer, without that foundation, you know, the work cannot really go forth as the way God wants it to. And so we thank the Lord for
this. Amen.
Oh,
that's the most important thing. That's the most important thing that we can give to each other is to pray for one another.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
God answers prayer.
With a humble heart. Hallelujah. Praise God. The Lord.
And we're in the fog, we're in
Amen.
the cloud
We're in
up
the
here.
cloud. Okay. Praise the Lord.
Awesome.
Hallelujah. The Lord bless you today and keep you. Make his holy face shine upon you. The Lord lift up his holy countenance upon you. Grant you peace. The Lord be gracious unto you today, saints. His name, authority, and character be upon your life and in you and filling you to overflowing in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Glory to the King, and we will see you tomorrow. Hallelujah.